Hello and welcome. Today, we're going to look at how you can use SharePoint to manage your content and teamwork when working in DocTo Help. Basically speaking, use a SharePoint library as the repository for your content. There are two ways you can do this. You can upload the content in your existing DocTo Help project to a SharePoint document library. Or you can download content that already exists in a SharePoint document library to a DocTo Help project. In either case, this integration allows you to take advantage of SharePoint's management features. This is typically used to manage content and facilitate review and contributions from people who are not working in DocTo Help. Note that DocTo Help can also publish output to SharePoint, but that is covered in a different video. Let's start with one of DocTo Help's Word sample projects. It is open on the screen you see here. By the way, SharePoint integration works with both HTML and Word source projects. To get started, we just need to click the Share button on the main toolbar. The SharePoint library wizard will open to guide us through the process. Here, we can type the URL to our document library, or we can click the Browse button to browse the SharePoint site and select or create a new library. Let's create a new library. Here you see the structure of our SharePoint site. And to create a new library, I just need to create a new folder. We'll call this repository. I select my new folder, okay, and now DocTo Help will create that folder for me. When I click Next, I can pick and choose the files I want to share, but I want to share them all, so I'll click Next again. And once I confirm, my content will be uploaded. Notice I can also choose to manage my media files, which are usually screenshots. I want to upload them too, so I'll click OK. Now we have icons next to our document files that indicate our project is being shared. The most fundamental feature here is check in and check out. When I'm ready to work on a document, I'll check it out so nobody else can edit it. Notice the green check mark. It indicates I have the document checked out and it is OK to edit. If somebody else had the document checked out, the check mark would be red and the document would be locked. Let's see what this looks like in SharePoint. Notice that the same document, developing software documentation, is checked out. I'll go ahead and check it in. Since these documents are in SharePoint, anybody can access, review, and contribute. For instance, let's say a reviewer wants to leave me a comment. I will pretend I am the reviewer, open a document, and leave a comment. First, I should check it out. A reviewer can come in and open the document and contribute content or leave comments. Let's say I want a newer screenshot to be used. I'll leave a Word comment, save the document, and then since Word and SharePoint are integrated, when I close the document, it will ask me if I want to check it in. I will do that. Now my comment and document is saved in SharePoint. Now let's see what this looks like in DocTo Help. When I come back to DocTo Help, you see it is in the state I left it in. That's because the project is not yet synchronized. To synchronize it, I just use the button, and DocTo Help will tell me what's been changed. I can accept the changes and click OK. Now, you can see that the document I had checked into SharePoint is checked in here too. Let's look at the document that the reviewer left a comment in. I can now see the comments, resolve them, delete them, and resynchronize the content. That was a quick overview of how DocTo Help's integration with SharePoint works. You can do much more, such as review version histories, look at comparisons, and assign document tasks. Also, remember this works for content created in DocTo Help's editor as well. To learn more and download a free trial, go to DocTo Help.com. Thanks for watching, and thanks for choosing DocTo Help.